Step two.
Multiplication?
Multiplication, right? I'm gonna go to multiplication. So I'm gonna do this. Opposite of this, correct?
Yes.
Opposite of this.
A over
all. A in the top.
Now what am I doing now?
Inverse.
Just tell me, what am I gonna do now?
A over all.
You know me, Burdette, from education. But wait, you know there's gonna be more. I also am looking for some literacy students. If you need your GED, and that means you don't have a GED or your high school diploma, it's equivalency, and you're not already in education, or maybe if you are, we can work with you. But if you have a job during the day.
Today I had a speech that I wrote. And when I wrote this speech, I was trying to fit a conventional narrative. I was trying to fit this conventional narrative that I felt was something that they did in a traditional space, right? And I really started thinking about that. And I came to the conclusion that we're not in a traditional space.
Welcome, sports fans, to the Pi Tsunami Show. I'm Professor Pi, and we're just starting to wrap up our section on fractions. Now, remember what a fraction is? A fraction is a part of something. One half is a fraction. You know what one half of something is?
It's homegrown art scene. Look up. Its new identity painted all over the city's walls, covered with murals. And starting today, even if you look down, it's much the same.
Off the top, I wanted to go to New York City for many reasons. The culture, the people, the food, the proximity to Europe, the opportunities, the architecture, the fact that it was the mecca of all things media. Basically, all the typical reasons.
As usual, she's called on her village, DJ Eddie Z. Motivational speaker Kevin Bracey. And SAC Skills Academy coaches Sam and Danielle.
What is leadership to mean?
Who she's been training with since she was 8.
Fly in a hot air balloon. Easy, right? Wrong. There's paperwork, safety precautions, and logistics to go over before even stepping into the basket.
Was on display at a festival this afternoon. It's all part of this exhibit called Tearing Walls Apart. You're looking at some of the art there. The creator of the project talks about how students were given free rein to paint the walls inside of the hotel.
Everything pretty much looks the same, except for some new things here and there. The Hammington Center being one of them. This is the new Crosby. The hangout center for the next generation, with Starbucks, amazing patio views, inspirational quotes, and fun around the corner.
Individuals, families, and businesses, they were all invited to participate. This is the second annual community cleanup, and organizers say they were happy to see the group of volunteers show up today. They also say that there was a lot less trash this year compared to last year.
The motion revolved around a sealed search warrant. On Wednesday, Judge Sweet postponed the decision on the motion to give a proper review. The sheriff's department was going to gather those items yesterday afternoon, but it could not happen until the judge made his ruling.
It's another day in Acatique, and the townspeople are already hard at work, making bricks, which the town is famous for, delivering fresh tortillas at your door, and serving local organic fruit in the plaza for breakfast. Compared to the U.S., life is pretty slow in Acatique.
Every year in Sacramento, this brunch today included all-you-can-eat food and also bottomless mimosas. Restaurants at Downtown Commons participating in the brunch included Echo and Rig, Punchbowl Social, Burger Lounge, Revival at the Sawyer, and also Panda Express.
Getting to see Oklahoma for the second time around, now as an adult, helped me appreciate the beauty of the U.S. Not only are the gas prices cheap, which is nice, but all the green, the brick houses, lack of traffic, and hospitality was a charm all in and of itself.
Halloween party for pediatric patients and their families today. Children were able to celebrate with costumes, games, and crafts. This was made possible through the Spirit of Halloween Children Program. The program hosts nearly 100 Halloween parties at hospitals. This happens around the country to bring the fun to patients who would otherwise miss out.
And stopping by GUTV humbled me. It gave me the extra push I needed to move forward, to live. Because Gonzaga will always be there. But before I said goodbye, I decided to get something off my bucket list. Wine tasting.